Wow. It sure is dark. And as usual, I'm wearing my sunglasses after dark, waiting for the sun to go up. Off to do some business in another city. I hope it will be profitable and that I'll be okay. Oh, people, you know, I think all kinds of thoughts, and January is kind of a gloomy time. You know, I think that whatever challenges we face in this incarnation or life, if you don't believe in reincarnation, if you think this is your only time around, fine. I don't personally believe that. I can remember way back, and I'm not nuts, but whatever. I see myself as an ongoing spirit with awareness and lessons that I have to learn. And I think that when we find ourselves in challenging situations, you know, I don't like all this throw your trust in the Lord stuff, because to some extent that's good, but to a great extent I think that we have to get beyond it and evolve. The challenges of life are given to us because those are steps we have to climb. If we are in an impoverished situation in this life, you know, starved for love, starved for money, starved for food, it might be, perhaps, because we were wealthy in the past and didn't handle that correctly. We may have been stingy. We may have not been generous. We may have been proud. And so, universe, in its wisdom, brought us around this time to live in privation, so that we have to long for money and riches and comfort, and perhaps not think that, I don't want to say that, I guess I'm saying that this might be our fault, but it goes beyond that, because actually what it is that it's a question of evolution. If we can think and feel our way out of it and get past it even just a little, I think we're set up better for the next time around. And if you're very traditional and you want to think of heaven and hell and going to your reward or to your punishment, then, well, I was raised by a Catholic mother who actually confessed to being agnostic, and I was raised in the Buddhist faith by a couple of beatniks, and my father was Protestant, and at one point I asked why we didn't go to any religious services, and my parents said, well, we'll take you around to a whole bunch of different ones, and you can pick the one that you like, and we'll support you in that. So I thought, well, that's reasonable, that sounds cool, and we went around to a bunch of them, and I wasn't interested by any of them, and I just said, I don't really want to go. They said, that's fine. But I ended up actually studying Buddhism for many years formally at university. I was almost a comparative religions major. That was getting kind of crazy. And I was married twice Jewish, and for the second marriage, I converted on the sly because he told me that his family absolutely couldn't accept if I wasn't Jewish, so I was going to have to fake it. So I did, and I did that for 12 years, no regrets. I studied Hinduism, I've studied early Christianity, which is very interesting, Native American cultures, and also I've studied the black arts, voodoo, witchcraft, if you will. I don't remember what else. And here in France, after I got the Jesus thing about 10 years ago, as I call it, I went to adult catechism, private, for quite a long period of time. That was very interesting. But I think that a lot of what we go through is a question of evolution. I did a rune reading for somebody about a year and a half ago. And he's very poor in this lifetime. And I'm able to do past life and future incarnation readings, which might all just be fluff, but I think my vision is clear. And I said to him, well, I've got some good news for you and some bad news. In your next incarnation, you're going to be a rich man. But here's the bad news. You're not going to appreciate it. You're going to think that you were just born into it, and you're not going to evolve. So try to think about that now. I don't want to be mean, but as frustrated as you might be now with your poverty, try to get out of it, really. Get a backbone and try to get out of it. And also be objective about it, because it looks to me for sure that your next incarnation, you will be a man again, and you'll be very well off. And you're going to blow it again. So, actually, he took the reading very well. He was quite amused, and it seemed to make some sense to him. I took him to church a bunch of times. He liked it a lot. All right, I hope I get there. I hope the trains are running. Bye.